Brad, last week you met with a board of inquiry at WWE Global Headquarters in Stamford, Connecticut to discuss this.
This is what we can't understand right here, Ryback. And here's the low blow right there. And then Maddox would follow with a fast count.
Brad, what possible explanation can you have for those actions? What did you tell the Board of Inquiry? And perhaps more importantly, are you working with Paul Heyman and WWE Champion CM Punk?
No. That was all me. That was my plan. All my life, all that I have ever wanted to do is to be a WWE superstar. All I have ever wanted to be was a WWE superstar. And for years, I tried to get my foot in the door, and for years, everybody shut the door in my face. I have sent tapes everywhere. I have sent tapes to the front office of talent relations. I have been to tryouts. I have been to Raw and SmackDown live events. I once paid $2,000 for a tryout. $2,000. And finally, after all of that, finally, I was given a chance with a developmental contract. And apparently, even down there, even there, I wasn't good enough. Why? Because I'm 6 feet tall, because I weigh 207 pounds, because I'm not a freak or a giant or a monster, I don't know, maybe because I don't have a mohawk or because I don't wear a mask or I don't know, maybe because I can't flip 3 times in the air and land on my feet. I don't know. But even when WWE officials told me that I would never make it to the main roster of the WWE, my dream didn't die. In fact, it got stronger because I want to be somebody, and I don't care how many people tell me that I'm nobody. So I made a vow to myself that I would do whatever it takes to get to the WWE. That's why I became a referee. And when Raw expanded to 3 hours and general manager AJ Lee called me for a job, all I needed was one chance to make an impact. I know what I did wasn't right. That was all me. That was all me. CM Punk had no idea what I was gonna do. He was just as surprised as Ryback was. He was just as surprised as all of you were. I made an impact. My actions, very simply, were driven by my desire to be somebody. Well, I'm somebody now. I'm famous now. People know my name everywhere. People know my name in England. My dream is to be a WWE superstar. That's why I want a contract and a match with Ryback. Because at this point, nobody's gonna forget who Brad Maddox is now. Thank you.
contract, huh? You want a contract and you want to face Ryback? Son, it's one thing to be famous. It's another thing to have a death wish. And by the way, I don't believe a word you're saying. I think you're lying through your teeth. I don't think you did this on your own. I think somehow you and Punk and Heyman are all intertwined in this. And I intend to get to the bottom of it. But you know what? You want a contract? All right. I'll give you $1 million contract if next week on Raw you can beat Ryback. Now get out of my ring.